A very good afternoon to all of you and welcome back. And today in this video, I will talk about the basic fundamentals of using Clipboard application. And basic fundamentals because this is an application which never shows itself and work in the background, just like Gravity, which never shows itself and work in the background, and which is also a sixth element. So in the same way, it is important to understand the work of Clipboard, which work in the background. So let's get started. So here at the bottom you can see the build of my Windows, and if you need more information about your Windows version, then you can hold down the start key and then press R to bring the run dialog box. And here you need to type winvar, which stands for Windows version, and hit the OK key. And here you can see which version of Windows 10 is installed on my system, that is 1903, and the build is 18970.1005. Hit the OK key. In Windows XP, you can find that application in the accessories section, and I have downloaded this file. Let me open this and you will see that blank view here. Let me minimize it and show you that how this clipboard behaves. So if I go to this website and select this paragraph and then right click on it and choose copy. Now I can paste that information in any text editor, either it is Notepad or WordPad. So if I click the edit menu and then click paste, then it will paste that copied information into this text editor. But where it is storing that information? Because if you copy something else, let's say I copy this next paragraph and then again paste into Notepad by clicking on the edit menu and then choose paste. Now you can see that the previous information has lost and it pasted the new contents that you copied. So that is how the clipboard behave in the background. Whenever you copy something from any location, either it is a web page or a file from your desktop, let's say I copy this paragraph again, then you can, so if you open the clipboard application, then you can see the same information has been copied here, right in this window. This application is not similar in Windows 10, and I will let you know about that later on. So if I now copy a file from this folder, let's say, let me open this folder and here I select any file, either it is an audio file, a presentation or a recording of Camtasia Studio, and I want to copy that file to some other location. So when I right click on this audio file, let's say, and choose copy, then you can notice that in clipboard, the path of that file has been noted down here. So if I minimize it and open any another folder and then right click and choose the paste command, then window will always look for the information in the clipboard. So whatever information will be available in the clipboard will get pasted into that particular location. So if I paste here, then it will paste that audio file into this folder. Now let's say I open this Notepad file and select all this matter and choose the copy command. And now I go to a folder and then choose the paste command. So you can see that this paste command is disabled here because you cannot paste a text inside a folder. You can only paste text between the text editor applications. Like I have copied the text from the Notepad file. Now I can go to the PowerPoint and I can paste that information into this text box. Just like that. But you cannot paste the text into a folder without creating any file. So you always have to paste the text inside a text file. Either it is a document or a TXT or a XLS file. Even you can paste that matter into Excel as well by clicking on the paste button, as you can see here. So the older version of Windows only store one last copy of the copied contents. So if you go and copy something else, let's say I copy this line, then the older information will get lost by default. You can also use these clipboard functions, like you can save this information to retain it later by clicking on the file menu and then choose save as, and then here I am going to give it a name, let's say demo, and save it. Now I again go to a web page and copy something else. Now the latest information will be here in the clipboard, but let's say you want the older one. So you have saved it into a file, then you can go to the file menu and then click open and then choose that clipboard file, which is demo.clp. CLP is extension of the clipboard files, and click open. And here is the older information that you copied. So that is how the Windows clipboard behave. But that is not similar in Windows 10. In Windows 10, if you want to bring the clipboard, then what you can do, you can hold down the Windows key and then press V to bring the history of clipboard. But as you can see that it can't show you history because by default clipboard is turned off in Windows 10. So you can either turn it on by clicking on this button, or you can go to the settings by clicking on the start menu and then click settings. And here under the system, go to the clipboard from the left side pane. And here you can turn on this option, save multiple items to the clipboard to use later. Press the Windows logo key plus V to view your clipboard history and paste from it. So if I am going to turn this on, and if you want to turn on this sync across devices feature, then you should also know about the user profile. So in Windows 10, you can create two kinds of user. Let me show you by going to control panel, and here under the users account, you can see that it is a local account, the teacher, and you can also create an online account in Windows 10, which can be used with Hotmail or Outlook account. So if you are using that online Microsoft account, then you can turn on this feature. So what will happen? You can set this option to automatically sync text that I copy. So all the history of clipboard will be stored on the cloud. And if you log in with the same ID and password to any another device, then you can also see the same clipboard history in that device as well. So that is what this function is used for. I am not going to use this, so I am going to turn this off. And later, if you want to clear the entire history of the clipboard, then you can come here and then click the clear button to remove all the contents of the Windows clipboard. So as I have turned on the setting, if now I press the Window plus V key, so right now this clipboard is empty. And if I go to this website again and scroll down and copy this paragraph, and if now I press start plus V key to bring the clipboard, then you can see the history here. And here you can also see a dotted button, and if you click this button, then you can delete this information from the clipboard. Let me copy it again and bring the clipboard by pressing start plus V. So let's say I want to paste this information into any text editor. So let's say I open Microsoft Word, and here I can bring the clipboard by pressing Window plus V key, and I can then click on a particular item to take it from the clipboard, and then the clipboard will automatically get hide. So that is how it behave in Windows 10. The good thing about Windows 10 clipboard is it can store multiple separate informations. So if I go to this website again, and here I copy two different paragraphs, one is this and second one this, then you can see that it stores both of the information and the earlier one as well. And you can also pin an information into the clipboard by clicking on this three dotted button and then choose pin. Now if I move to any other application and want to paste some information from the clipboard, then I can press Window plus V key and then can choose which information I want in that application. Now let's talk about Microsoft Office Clipboard, and for that I am going to open Microsoft Word. And here in the Home tab, you can see this clipboard section here, which contain cut, copy, paste and Format Painter command. And if you want more information about Format Painter, then you can watch one of my video, and the link of that video is given in the cards. And if you see other applications of Microsoft Office like Excel or PowerPoint, then you can find the same clipboard section in these applications as well. So the one thing I would like to tell you about clipboard is that it is not visible by default. So as I am copying this text from this web page and go to Microsoft Word and paste it here, now if I select this text up to here and click copy command, and again if I select this text here and use copy, then you will never notice that the clipboard is working in the background. So if I click the paste button, you always get the last copied item. So as I have copied this last line of this paragraph, then it pasted that content only. If you click that button, which is called dialog box launcher, then it will bring the clipboard pane and you can see all the items that you have previously copied. By default, if you are just using copy and paste command, then it will always paste the last copied content. But if you open this clipboard pane, then you can choose which item you want to paste. If you click on that particular item, then it will get pasted. You can close this clipboard pane by clicking on this close button and can bring it back by clicking on this dialog box launcher button. And if you want to clear all these items from the clipboard, then you can click on clear all. And if you want to paste all of them inside your document, then you can click on paste all. And if I switch to Excel and open the clipboard of Microsoft Excel, then you can see all the same items right here as well and in the PowerPoint as well. So let me delete this. And if you want to delete a particular item, then you can click on this drop down button and then can choose delete. You can also move this clipboard pane by clicking on this drop down button and choose move, and then you can drag and drop to any side of the screen. You can also move that clipboard pane without using that move command from the drop down menu by just holding it from the title bar and then can drag at any position of the screen. So as we were talking about how to use clipboards using the text, now we will talk about how to use clipboard and how it behaves on images. And for that I am going to insert two different images using the online pictures from the insert tab. And here I will choose animals and will take this picture. And again I go to online pictures and this time I choose fruits and insert this Apple logo here. So the first thing, I will reduce the size of these pictures by holding the Ctrl Alt and Shift keys. Also this one. Now always keep in mind that you cannot move the images freely in Microsoft Word unless you set the position or wrap text. So I am going to set the wrap text to scale and now I can freely move this picture. And I will also do the same for this picture as well. And you can see two different tabs, shape format and picture format, for both of these pictures. And I will insert a third picture, but this time from my computer using the insert pictures option. And here I am going to use a screenshot, let's say this one, and insert it and reduce the size and change the wrap text to scale so I can move it anywhere in the document. Now you should note one thing, that on this picture it is only showing one tab, picture format, but on both of these pictures it is also showing a shape format. I will tell you later on that why it is showing two different tabs for these two pictures. Now let's copy this picture and it will take that picture into the clipboard. So I will do the same for these two pictures as well. So as we have these three pictures in clipboard, now I am going to delete all of them. So the clipboard not only stores the text information, but it can also store the images as well. So if now I click on this Apple icon, it has saved the wrap text layout for this picture, which we have set in previous step to scale. Now I can move this picture freely and I can do this with this picture as well. So let me delete these two pictures and insert this third one. So if now I select this picture and go to the picture format, then you can notice that it has not saved that wrap text formatting which we have set to scale. So picture inserted from computer and showing only one tab, picture format, will lost their wrap text or position formatting. So you have to reset it again and then you can move this picture freely. So if I again insert this picture, then you can see that it is bringing two different tabs, shape format and picture format, because this picture has been inserted inside a shape. And if I go to shape format and choose shape fill and fill it with a color, then you can see the background of that shape. So that is why it is showing two different tabs, but not on this third picture, because we have inserted this picture using the insert picture command from computer. So that is why it doesn't show two different tabs and do not save the wrap text and position formatting inside the clipboard. So the last thing that I would like to tell you about Microsoft Office Clipboard is you can also use it for symbols and equations. So let me give you an example, and for that I will move to PowerPoint, and here I will insert a picture on which I was working for my blog post. So I needed a screenshot of this PowerPoint screen along with these numbers, and for this number what I was doing, I was inserting symbols. And to insert symbols in PowerPoint, what you have to do, you have to use the word art and then go to insert tab, then choose symbol, and here I was using the winding fonts, and scroll down a little bit, and here you can find this number and can click insert, and that will get inserted inside the word art text box. Now you can select that shape and can change the formatting as you like and increase or decrease the size. So here you can note down the size, and now if I need to use these symbols many times, then what I can do, I can open the Office Clipboard and can save this number by clicking on the copy button. So I can repeat these steps for further numbers, like I can insert the second symbol and can save it to the clipboard by clicking on the copy. So for the next screenshot, let me close this presentation and open a new one. So let's say in this new presentation, I want to insert that symbol over a picture. So I first insert a picture. So if you want the same symbol on top of this picture, then you can simply click on this button in the clipboard, and that way it will get inserted. So let's say you need to type these number to point out something over the pictures, and you have to do this on many pictures, then you can once save all these number inside the clipboard, and then whenever you need a particular number, then you can click on the clipboard item to insert it into the presentation or document. So that way it can save you a lot of time. You can also watch my video on how to use symbols efficiently in Microsoft Office, and the link of that video is also given in the cards. So finally, I will tell you about the clipboard options here. And as you can see, show Office Clipboard icon on taskbar is checked by default, and show status near taskbar when copying. So what that mean, if I now select this item and click the copy button, then you can see the status of the clipboard that it has 6 items out of 24. And you also see a clipboard icon in the system tray. And if you have closed the clipboard from Office application, and now if you double click on this icon, then it will bring the clipboard. Now let's talk about rest of 3 options. And the second option, show Office Clipboard when Ctrl C pressed twice. So if I check this, and now I type something and select it and close the clipboard. Now if I press Ctrl C twice, then it will automatically bring the clipboard. Now we will talk about collect without showing Office Clipboard. If I check this option, and now if I type something, and select it and copy, then you can notice that it is not bringing the Office Clipboard now automatically. But the option to bring the clipboard by pressing the Ctrl C twice is checked, then pressing Ctrl C twice again will bring the Office Clipboard. So the last option is show Office Clipboard automatically. And if you check this option, then whenever it will require to show you the clipboard, then it will bring that screen. Now let's talk about the last option, show Office Clipboard automatically. And if you check this item, then the show Office Clipboard when Ctrl C pressed twice will get disabled automatically. So if now I select both of these lines and press the Ctrl C once, then it will not bring the Office Clipboard automatically. But if you press the Ctrl C again, then it will automatically bring the clipboard if needed, even if the show Office Clipboard when Ctrl C pressed twice is disabled. So this option bring the clipboard automatically whenever it required. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for your time and have a wonderful day.